Whoa. Let's hold it right there. How do we know where we're going if we don't know where we've come from? Let's go back. Way back. To the beginning. The history of Babylon Lodge number 793, FNAM, begins just before the 20th century, in the year 1887. The same year as the 100th anniversary of the signing of the United States Constitution. Over a decade before the invention of the Model T by Henry Ford. Only 1 week prior, the United States Congress leased a piece of land on a remote island in the middle of the Pacific. This piece of land would become Pearl Harbor Naval Base. In February of that year, a few German Freemasons met in a small town in Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania, and created what would become Groundhog's Day. Many members of the fraternity were very active during this period of our history. These members worked diligently and faithfully towards the formation and freedom of our country. This was only 20 years or so after the conclusion of the American Civil War, and they never gave up the task of keeping us free. A group of 22 such men living in the area of Babylon petitioned the Grand Lodge of Masons in the state of New York to create and form a new lodge. In 1887, the village of Babylon and the county of Nassau were not in existence. The village was not founded until 1893, and Nassau County until 1898. These men, Theodore C. Fletcher, Henry Livingston, Richard Higbee Jr., Charles Searle, Henry Seaman, Philip Sammis, John Jarvis, Charles Hendrickson, Dachio Falconer, George Dingenthal, Alex Mathias, Henry Eric, George Burr, Samuel DeForest, Philip Seaman, Harold Finley, Carl Schmidt, Leonard Fischel, Norman Smith, Samuel Muncy, Charles White, James McLachlan, first met in the Willits Building and held the first communication under dispensation of Babylon Lodge on Thursday evening, January 27th, 1887. The Willits Building was a three-story brick structure locating on the southeast corner of Main Street and Fire Island Avenue in Babylon Village. The first floor was occupied by the Dowden Brothers General Store, with offices on the second floor. The lodge room was located on the third. Nearby was the office of the newspaper, Southside Signal, published by our second worshipful master, Henry Livingston, and his son Albert. The paper and its banner, the following, a journal of island enterprise and information, its aim to benefit others, in the reasonable hope of being thereby enabled to benefit itself. Its policy, the Golden Rule. 1887 was the paper's 18th year of publication and was published every Saturday. The following articles were most likely written by Henry Livingston himself and were published in the Southside Signal during the year 1887. Saturday, January 29th, 1887. A Masonic Lodge is an institution that many of the citizens of Babylon have long been desirous of seeing established here. At last, the efforts of those interested in the matter have been successful. On Monday, a dispensation to organize Babylon Lodge, FNAM, has been granted by the Grand Master of the State. On Thursday evening, the first meeting under the dispensation was held at Oddfellows Hall. The following officers were named in the dispensation: Theodore Fletcher, Master; Henry Livingston, Senior Warden; Richard Higby Jr., Junior Warden. The other officers will be filled by appointment. The Lodge has a membership of 21, and there are about 30 applicants for initiation. The meetings of the Lodge will be hereafter held on Wednesday evening of each week. A Masonic Lodge made up of true Masons is a credit to any place, and we are gratified to know that Babylon is now the home of this ancient and honorable order, which has withstood the ravages of time through many centuries, and has quietly alleviated suffering, buried the dead, cared for the widows and orphans, and taught men to lead purer and better lives. In June of 1887, at the 17th Communication, Grand Lodge officers were present to dedicate the lodge and install the officers. Right Worshipful George Rowe, Grand Secretary, read the warrant from the Grand Lodge of the State of New York, dated June 10, 1887, empowering Babylon Lodge No. 793, FNAM, to work under the leadership of Worshipful Theodore C. Fletcher. In 1888, Henry Livingston became master, and for his work setting up Babylon Lodge and putting it on the right course, was awarded a lovely past master's jewel. In March of 1888, the most severe snowstorm to strike Long Island in many years occurred. However, this blizzard of 88 did not deter the brothers from meeting on March 14th. So much so that the secretary made mention in the meeting of the minutes that the snow was at least 3 feet deep, with drifts to a depth of 15 feet in many places. My brothers, it speaks a lot how much this lodge meant to the brothers that they braved those elements to go meet with each other. In 1890, trustees were empowered to lease the upper floor of a proposed new building to be erected on the north side of Main Street, between Norton and Siegel Incorporated and the Babylon National Bank and Trust Company, a building which still stands today as a restaurant. The lease was for 5 years and the rent was not to exceed $200 a year. The first meeting in the new lodge was held on April 1, 1891. The move took place during the year of James W. Eaton as master. The building was occupied by a post office on the first floor, but was subsequently destroyed by a fire, which we were lucky to save most of the lodge furniture. The return of the first master, Worshipful Theodore C. Fletcher, in 1892, marked the year that John N. Fraser of Meridian Lodge No. 691 was elected an honorary member of Babylon Lodge. It was through his efforts that Babylon Lodge was able to obtain its dispensation. On the 20th day of January, 1897, a resolution was adopted and approved for the competency of Massapequa Lodge No. 822 to confer the 3 degrees. Massapequa Lodge, now Lindbrook Massapequa Lodge No. 822, located in Rockville Center, received its charter on June 26th. In March 1910, the lodge purchased Halcyon Hall on Deer Park Avenue, the name by which the building was known for $6,000. This was the home of our lodge until we took possession and ownership of our present temple. In the good old days, Halcyon Hall was occupied by the owner, James H. Arnold, as a feed store on the first floor, while the upper hall was rented for dances, entertainment, political rallies, and vaudeville shows. A huge stove held a prominent place near the rear of the hall. Plenty of peanut shells were evidence of the fun that happened the night before. The first communication in this new lodge room was held on the evening of September 28, 1910. At that time, gifts of furnishing were received from a number of brethren. The Grand Master, Most Worshipful Robert Judson Kenworthy, and his staff attended the dedication ceremonies. A banquet was held at Watson House preceding the ceremonies. A check of an old map of the village reveals that the Watson House was located south of Prospect Street on Fire Island Avenue. In 1915, we held our first public installation of officers. Henry S. Johnson was installed master. About 100 guests were present. In August of that year, one of our founding brothers, Samuel A. Higby, passed away. Higby Lane in West Islip was named in his honor. In November of 1916, Babylon Lodge members were guests of Pyramid Chapter number 594, Order of the Eastern Star, the occasion being the presentation of their charter by the Order of Eastern Star Grand Chapter officers. As the armistice ended World War I in 1918, many men returned to Babylon, and our membership stood at 198, an increase of 98 brothers in 15 years. Robert N. Overton was master that year. There was considerable degree work during the next 2 years that kept the masters Norman H. Smith and Paul Paley quite busy. On September 27, 1920, the brothers were summoned to vote on the proposition to grant the Farmingdale brothers permission to establish a lodge in Farmingdale. The proposition was led by Harry M. Ketchum, who was made a Master Mason in Babylon Lodge on May 13, 1908, and served as installing officer of incoming officers of our lodge with great efficiency and humor for over 30 years. A similar proposition was asked by the Brothers of Amityville, led by Worshipful Arthur C. Wells. Both propositions were granted, and in humble appreciation of our efforts to help them establish Bethpage Lodge, number 975, in Farmingdale, Worshipful Harry Ketchum presented us with a small silver trowel in 1923. When Henry W. Thomas closed his year as master in 1923, the lodge had a membership of 243 master masons. During his year, there was a visitation from the Square Club of Jamaica Lodge number 546 that conferred the third degree on five candidates. The president of the club was accompanied by a delegation of 172 members. Once again, Right Worshipful Harry Ketchum and Right Worshipful Brother R.W. Abbott installed the offices of Babylon Lodge for the year of 1938. Worshipful Charles A. Rogers assumed the duties of master. A fellowcraft class comprised of men from Lindenhurst Village was given an open examination on the floor of the lodge for the first time in many years. I ask you this, when was the last time you saw an open examination? And do you know what an open examination is? March ushered in the homecoming meeting in Babylon Lodge as Bethpage Lodge number 975 and Amityville Lodge number 977 returned to their mother lodge for a splendid reunion. At our installation in January of 1945, large delegations from neighboring lodges were received to honor the Worshipful Brother Thomas, who was serving a second term as master. Right Worshipful Harry M. Ketchum was made an honorary member of Babylon Lodge that year. It was a token of appreciation for the many years of service of the officers and brethren of the lodge. The sublime degree of Master Mason was conferred that year by members of Babylon Post number 94 of the American Legion. Every station and place was accompanied by a legionnaire in uniform. As 1945 drew to a close, we rejoiced in the fact that the war was over and looked forward to celebrating with our returning brethren. Our most illustrious installing team was at it again in 1946 with the installation of Worshipful Brother William R. Gagin and his fellow officers. The Grand Master recommended the formation of a victory chest that year to care for the sick and disabled. Our late brother Albert C. Livingston left $5,000 for reducing the lodge indebtedness. He also left various jewels and awards which were presented to him and his late father, Henry Livingston. The lodge rejoiced in the fact that all the bonds were retired in 1946. In 1948, the Grand Master's message made four recommendations. First, to support the Masonic Brotherhood Foundation. Second, to visit old and infirm brothers. Three, to sponsor Demolay. And four, to subscribe to the Masonic Outlook magazine. In 1949, we were the first lodge in Suffolk County to exceed its 1948 contributions. Plans were discussed relative to renovating the lodge building. Worshipful Charles F. Feifel announced the offer of Brother Erastus Munson to give us 100 feet of frontage on Montauk Highway, free and clear. A resolution of thanks was drawn up. An initiation fee was raised from $75 to $100. In 1950, the Committee on Modernization reported that it would cost $16,000 to renovate the lodge building. A resolution was read for the third time, moved and carried to change the annual dues from $10 to $12. There were many discussions for the next couple of years concerning the new temple. The deed of the land, donated by Brother Erastus Munson, was received and accepted in 1951. A resolution was made in 1953 to empower a committee to solicit funds for construction of our new temple, and 64 pledges totaling $8,360 were received. Two special resolutions passed in 1954, one establishing a special fund for the new temple and another for a reserve fund. It was also resolved to sell the old building on Deer Park Avenue for $30,000. A resolution was passed to purchase a 70-foot by 140-foot plot adjacent to the basic 100 feet available on Montauk Highway. The last third degree in the old temple was given on April 27, 1955, at the 1,405th communication. At our final meeting, "Auld Lang Syne" was sung by all. Future meetings were scheduled for the Oddfellows Hall located on Deer Park Avenue. The final plans for the new temple were given and approved in 1956 with $49,000 cash on hand. The contract to build the new temple was duly awarded to Brother Arthur W. Anderson during 1957 for $103,144. Our trustees were empowered to obtain mortgages, and we purchased a piece of land 80 feet by 156 feet south of the temple from Erastus Munson for $4,000. By special permission of the contractor, we held our first rehearsal for degree work on March 17, 1958 at our new temple on Montauk Highway. The last meeting at Oddfellows Hall was held on June the 2nd. On September 10, 1958, the cornerstone laying and dedication ceremonies for the new temple took place with the most worshipful H. Lloyd Jones, Grand Master, presiding. Among the dignitaries present were Judge Arthur Cromarty and the Mayor of Babylon Village, Gilbert C. Hance. Our mortgage balance on February 5, 1961 amounted to $44,972.54. Miss Julia Livingston bequeathed a legacy of $50,000 to our lodge, and a $3,000 debt due to Pyramid Chapter Number 594, Order of the Eastern Star, was ordered paid. On May 31, 1962, the mortgage on our temple was satisfied. On January 10, 1968, Worshipful Herman F. Hines, Sr. was installed as the 69th Master of Babylon Lodge. On this occasion, we honored Brother Lewis Moore for his 20 years as Tyler of the Lodge. His picture hangs over the Tyler's chair to this day. On March 25, 1987, our brothers from the Suffolk, Nassau, and New York City Police Square Clubs conferred the Master Mason degree on proficient brothers. Worshipful Luchtenberg graciously presented the lodge his Revolutionary War-style tricorn hat, which he so proudly wore during his tenure. Worshipful Master John S. Young accepted on behalf of the lodge and ordered it to be placed in the beautiful display case created through the efforts of Worshipful Michael Mimosa. The lodge was honored on June 10th by the presence of Most Worshipful Robert C. Singer, Grand Master Masons of the State of New York, as we celebrated the 100th anniversary of the granting of the warrant from the Grand Lodge of the State of New York. To say that Babylon Lodge is important to Masonry in Long Island is truly an understatement. We existed before the formation of the Village of Babylon, before Nassau County existed. We are the mother lodge of four other lodges: Massapequa Lindbrook Lodge, Amityville Lodge, Bethpage Lodge, and Bayshore Lodge. And the love for the craft of our Babylon brothers is visible everywhere. The building we're in today is made possible by Brother Erastus Munson. Brother Henry Livingston's family left us a large sum of money in 1961, which cleared our indebtedness to the bank and allowed the brothers to practice the craft without worry of paying a mortgage. The craft meant that much to him, so much so that his family knew that that's what he would want.